going to be downloading Duolingo. I'm so scared. I'm so scared. I'm scared he's gonna like enter my back door or something. I don't know, bro. I wanna see if there's ratings. Where's his ratings? Sorry. Bro. Get these goofy messages out. I wanna see. Oh, these are serious. I thought there was gonna be like. These are serious. I thought I was gonna be like, OMG, he entered my home. This was a great app until they changed their format to a learning path. Alright, you know what? This video is just gonna be reading rating instead, but I'm still gonna download it. To a learning path. Since the update, all the lesson icons on my Chromebook has disappeared. I can only do practice lessons on the app, and I have to go to Duolingo's website to start any new lessons. I contacted the health center about my problem, but never received a response. I tried reinstalling the app, but nothing happened. I have to wait months to see if there's any updates. If they would fix this problem? Spelling error, haha. But none have. Very, very disappointing. Oh my god, bro. The latest update has good ideas based on the animation that it showed. It worked out. However, it feels incomplete. The only way I'm able to actually do lessons is through the streak warning when the deadline comes close or an appropriate notification shows up. I have no idea how the lessons are normally clickable on the unit's pull-up guidebook paragraphs. So this is handy, but is not what I'm looking for. Good experience otherwise. And I hope I am hopeful. No, you are not. Actually, yes, you are. You are not, though. You are just a hater. You are just a hater, Samantha McNabb. Sydney Brake, you deserve a golden crown. Alright, Ryan Cook, what do you have to say? Duolingo has been my main super mental learning app. As I moved to South America to learn Spanish. I really liked it until they recently changed the program. I lost my progress, lost my access to very helpful stories, and I lost the ability to jump around and study and review content that was helpful to me. I am very disappointed that I was forced into this change. It is a major change, a major departure. from the learning method I was working. I have canceled my subscription. Well, why would you buy a subscription from Duolingo, first of all? He literally threatens to freaking kidnap our family, and he got the FBI. I need to see more reviews. Great, now I gotta read it. Okay, I gotta read it like this now. You know, it's like really trash. Hold on, I just have to fix my bed real quick. Because this is where I record. Alright, we already read you. Also, you did not help, like, SMH. Bring back the old interference. The new user interface is awful and does not display correctly on my tablet now. It was fine before the change. Half of the time I can't even access lessons because it will not display the lesson buttons. I have to use vertical mode on my tablet that renders me my keyboard unless the old version was much better. Very frustrating. Shut up, you're just a hater. I enjoy using... Oh my god, he broke paragraph. I enjoy using Duolingo. I enjoy using Duolingo. However, I have not enjoyed the new learning path for various reasons, including that it is very annoyingly slow and forces me to work on topics I already know. I have unlock stores beyond the limits of my unit, yet I cannot access them. I would like it to be better if there was a way to switch between the old dashboard and the current learning path. I am not saying that the new learning path is bad. However, I believe people who want the old way should be able to. SMH, you're just a hater. Just a hater. Also, like, shout out to, like, all these people, by the way, if they have, like, a YouTube channel. Alright, I want to end it here, but at the same time, I don't, so I'm just gonna keep going. I've been using Duolingo for a year and learned a lot of Spanish words. The lessons are usually fun, except if I make more than 3 mistakes, then I either have to lose credit for a lesson or pay money to buy tokens to continue that lesson. I understand that Duolingo is trying to make money, but I would rather sit through an ad than pay for tokens. I actually agree with you on that one. You're not a hater. Alright, Nathan Frederick. Who has that name? Yeah, I'm not reading those. I want the... Oh. So silly me. I paid for the annual subscription. To that point, I enjoyed the product. I figured, why not? With about a couple of months to go before it expired. My account got hacked and I lost access to it. You would think maybe they would help me now? Nope, no response to the email I found on the other website. I lost so much progress coupled with unsecretary customer service. Save your time. Use it for free, but I don't trust them to help you at all. I've moved on. Yeah, but that's not their fault, though. That's not their fault, though. That's kind of your fault. Like, how did you need to make a more complex password, bro? So, sorry. I just zoned off for a second. I had this on my phone, but when I downloaded it on my Chromebook, it was a mobile way. It was almost made it inaccessible. And when it was accessible, it was difficult to use. Long story short, I would not recommend this for Chromebook. Otherwise, it's a great app and really helpful for learning new languages. Honestly, I agree with that. Here, let me see if I have it on my tablet and it'll be the same thing, but no. A Google user. Okay, I'll read that in a second. Hold on. I need to check something. Duo. Oh my god, I have it. I can get it, like, right now, bro. Wait, are the same... The ratings are, like, so bad on my mobile. Hold on, I'll be right back. Hold on. Yeah. Hold on. Okay, I have to go for now. I'll post another video on this in like a few minutes. So. Right.